part 2 of self-defense techniques. The first one, escape from rear neck choke. What if you're grabbed by the neck from behind? Now we'll show you a simple technique to save yourself. To free your neck from his hand, press the front part of the elbow, also called the antecubital part, which will injure him for a moment, enough for you to make your next move. The next one, escape from neck choke and counterattack. When you're grabbed by the neck, hold both of his hands, bring your leg across his front leg, and then use your body weight to pull him down. Then you can attack. Third, escape when grabbed and dragged from behind as well as from front. When grabbed from the back, bend your body forward 90 degrees, which will ensure a gap between you and him, after which you can kick at his groin. When grabbed from the front, push him at his waist and then thrust your knee upwards at his body. A knee from the back leg is preferred, which will give more force and do more damage. But if you're not able to push him away, then you can poke his eyes and then attack. If you're being carried off, with one hand grab his hair, with the other grab his chin and then twist it to save yourself. Fourth, escape from hair pulling and dragging. If you're being pulled by the hair, slightly bend your head backwards, turn your body around and then kick at his groin. Or you can grab his hand and his neck to pull him to a deadly knee attack. But if it's pulled from the front, grab his hand just as shown, bring your leg across his front leg, throw him to the ground and then attack. Now if two girls are engaged in a cat fight, pulling each other's hair, and you're one of them, then you can win by pulling and pushing her hair downwards. Or you can bring one of your leg across hers and pull her sideways by her hair. So that's the end of the part 2 video. Please like and subscribe for more.